Going into the day, the Missouri Tigers sat in the driver's seat at the Columbia Regional. Mizzou had not lost in the double elimination tourney. Nebraska had one loss. That meant the Tigers had two chances to knock their former Big 12 rivals out of the NCAA tournament and advance to the Super Regional round. Didn't go well in the first game, though. Alora Marble, the former Blair Oaks Falcon, pitching for Missouri. Haley Decker, remember that name. Two-run home run in the bottom of the first. It was 2-0 Huskers. Tigers got a run back in the second, then took the lead in the third. Angela Randazzo doubles off the left field fence. Two runs come in. It's 3-2 Missouri. Huskers answer right back in the bottom of the third. There's Haley Decker again. Another two-run home run, 4-3 Nebraska. And that jump-started a 7-run inning for the Huskers. Austin Ernest goes deep. Just over the wall, that's a 3-run home run. 9-3 Nebraska on top. Huskers rolling to an 11-4 win in game one against Marble and the Tigers. That set up a winner-take-all game two this afternoon. One more battle between the Tigers and Huskers to determine a regional champion. Top of the first, look who it is. Haley Decker of Nebraska. 2-run homer, her third of the day. It's 2-0 Huskers. Casey Stengel settled in, pitched well until this. Fourth inning, two on. Kiki Stokes, only 3 home runs all year. That's a 3-run blast, a killer. It's 5-0 Nebraska. Missouri finally gets on the board in the bottom of the fifth. Kelsey Roth leading off with a home run. That made it a 5-1 game. But the Huskers put it away in the seventh. Guess who? It's Haley Decker. Home run number 4 on the day. Another 2-run blast. Have a day, why don't you? 7-1 Huskers, they tack on another. Tigers, no answer. There's the final out. Huskers celebrate an 8-1 win. They win twice against Missouri today. Combined score of 19-5 in those two games. Nebraska hit 7 home runs. The Tiger season comes to an end.
The first inning, you know, it does deflate you a little bit. You're hoping to score first, and then the ball Randazzo hit. You know, I thought for sure that was over the right fielder's head, and she makes a great play on it and takes the wind out of you again. And then they come back and bang a few more home runs, and they were just by far and away the better team today.
It's really sad and humiliating, and every emotion that you can think that could be negative is it's all piled on right now just because you have so much potential and you don't fulfill it.
Hats off to Nebraska. They were the better team today. But, you know, this wasn't our end goal by any stretch of the imagination. So there's a lot of talent coming back. They're a great, great group of girls and an awesome group of coaches. So they'll be back.
Mackenzie Sykes, one of only 2 seniors on this team this year. Nebraska moves on to face Alabama next weekend. Tigers season is over at 43-18. They fail to make it to a Super Regional for the first time since 2007. The Mizzou men's golf team is getting set for its first NCAA championship appearance in 9 years. The Tigers took third in this weekend's Columbia Regional at Old Hawthorne. Tigers shot 27 under par as a team this weekend, finishing behind Oklahoma State and Arkansas. Tiger senior Emilio Quartero took individual honors, finishing the 3-day event at minus 11.
It's a great feeling. It's so overwhelming because we were close for 2 years, my freshman and junior year. I just don't have any words for it. It's just unbelievable the fact that I'm not leading, but just being part of this. It's a great journey, great teammates, and I will miss this forever.
It's big from the SEC move. You want to be able to show that you can compete with them. And to make it to the next stage, where only 30 teams advance, that's a pretty big step for us, and it's going to get us going in the right direction for the next 5 years or so.
The Tigers, one of 30 teams that will take part in the NCAA championships, 10 of those from the SEC, by the way. The event begins Friday at Prairie Dunes Country Club in Hutchinson, Kansas.